Hey, welcome back. Today we're covering how Copilot handles VBA in Microsoft Excel. Now, my name is Victor Cuevas, and I'm the founder of the Knowledge Jar. This channel, you can learn how to use AI for your business, job, or personal use. Appreciate a like and a subscribe to get the video out to others. Check out the free resources in the comment section below. So first, let's break down what Excel VBA actually is. VBA stands for Visual Basic for Applications. In simple terms, it's a programming language that allows you to automate tasks in Excel. If you're constantly repeating the same actions over and over and over again, you may consider writing a VBA script, it's also called a macro, to do it for you automatically. This can save you tons of time and reduce errors in your work. So let's head over to Excel, check out an example. Now here in Excel, we have a table of historical shoe and accessory purchases at a small shop in the mall. We also have a summary data set here on the right that tells us how the average quantity and revenue purchased for each month. Now we have one challenge with this summary data. Anytime a product is not purchased during the month, we get the division by zero error. Show you here, I can change this from March to September. You get the error. Come over here, maybe to August. And you see here, several errors as well. Now let's see how many formulas exist in this worksheet. On the ribbon, I'm gonna click on the Home tab. Then on the Find button, I'm gonna click it, and then I'm gonna choose Formulas. Now it looks like we have one in column C. I'm gonna click in here in the cell. You can see that it transforms the order date to the text formatted month. This is then passed to the month field on the summary view. We also have formulas for average quantity and average revenue. Now, normally we would need to wrap an if error function to resolve this across all the cells, but let's see if Copilot can take on this task. All right, first let's head over to the ribbon, home tab. I'm gonna click on the Copilot button to activate it. And in the prompt window, I'm gonna enter write a macro for this worksheet that ensures all formulas have an if error function. And if there is an error, then the value will be quotation, which is blank. I'll hit enter. So we get our script. I'm gonna scroll up and you can get our explanation. Here's our script and steps on how to paste this script. You may need your developer tab open. And how do you get your developer tab? You can ask the question, how to enable the developer tab? And then I can scroll up and you can see here, you just go to File, Options, click on Customize Ribbon, and then I'm gonna scroll down and you wanna make sure that your Developer tab here is activated. And you just click OK. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to copy this script and head over to Developer, then Visual Basic, bring this over, say, Insert module, and I'm simply just gonna paste that script. And let's scroll down. We see these errors, and I'm just gonna hit run. So we have this runtime error 1004. So I'll hit end, and I'm gonna tell Copilot the script generated an error 1004. Hit enter. Oh, I do have one thing I need to do. You can see right here, I have to have it macro enabled for this workbook. So File, Save As, Browse, and I'll just put this on my desktop. And you wanna choose Macro Enabled, and I'm gonna call this too. That's it. All right, so next, you can see here the new version includes an error handler that will display a message box with the error order number and description. So let's go ahead and paste this new updated script. So here, just gonna delete this, paste this, and now it's gonna run. No errors. And you can see right here, it looks like it works. So let's change some of the months. Let's go March, go to September. There's no errors. Drop down, August, there's no errors. So this is really good. If you're new to Microsoft Excel macros, using Copilot is an excellent way to shortcut the implementation process. Our final lesson will cover Python in Excel. So I'll see you in the next lesson.